Hey YouTubers, how's it going? It's Andrew here, obviously watching TK4238. Just a quick update blog thing. Probably wondering why I'm pointing the camera towards a model of a Aston Martin DB7. Well, I'm doing this handheld, so excuse the wobbly cameras. Bought this on eBay secondhand with a view to using it to make a book trailer. A Hollywood style, well, certainly a film-like trailer for a book, a novel, written by Simon D. Smith, which is on Amazon. It's on my channel link. Now, the reason why I've got the car, it's a 1/18th scale DB7 made by Maisto, made in Thailand. Quite nicely detailed, opening bonnet, doors, boot lid, working suspension, working steering. And the interior, let me just excuse the mess, by the way. I've got so many projects on, I really need to sort this out. Right, just going to try and get in here. Hey, look at that walnut dash. Not really, obviously, it's just a paint job. Quite nicely detailed. Obviously you've got great big inaccurate hinges, which is typical of diecast models, but I'm not really filming. I don't think the sequence that I need this for. I won't have to worry about the door hinges. And you're probably wondering why I've got baker foil down here. Well, what I'm doing is going to be replacing, cutting off the wings, bonnet and the front, and then replacing them with aluminium copies. Thin aluminium, because I need, in the sequence, I need to show damage as accurately and as realistically as I can for a 1/18th scale model. It's not going to be easy. It's going to be obviously it's a zero budget production, so couldn't hire a DB7, obviously, for obvious reasons. Can't wreck a DB7. The sequence involves it falling into something, a lake or whatever, so so hence the model. Now, with luck and a slight Vaseline smear over the lens as they used to do in the I think they still do in some of the films, it's going to be a distance shot. It's going to be a long shot of it driving off something, so, and through a fence. But obviously I want to show damage. There's a few videos on YouTube where someone's rolling a toy down a slope. It looks quite nice, actually, the footage. I'll try and find the link for you on that one. And I've also put up footage of a DB9 sort of being dropped, just to see effects. I was testing this camera. I'm filming this on the Nikon Coolpix S9100. It's got a slo-mo facility on it. It can be called either 120 frames a second or 240 frames a second. 120 frames a second in standard definition, it's not bad. So yeah, that's what I was going to, obviously in the edit I can then sort of zoom in on the image so it's still the correct sort of widescreen, 16:9. But yes, that's the car. Obviously going to take the badges off. We're going to put a number plate on it. And as I say, it's got working suspension, working steering, suspension at the rear. It's got springs have sagged a bit because it actually sinks low, so I'll probably be stretching the springs a bit. It's going to be filmed at 120 frames a second, which is not ideal for a 1/18th scale model based on the formula, but obviously it's going to be within the ballpark. I can always tweak it in edit. I think the hardest part is, because I'll be green screening it, the background that is, and I'm going to have to dust it down. So it's a work in progress at the moment. But the hardest bit will be to make these out of aluminium that can dent realistically. Because, bear in mind, this is a diecast model. If you'd scaled this up to full-size car, it would be armour plated. I mean, look, I'm just going to show you. There you go. Look at the thickness of that outer skin. It's probably the scale equivalent of several inches. The car wouldn't even move. Likewise, if the outer panels on a DB7 are, I think, a mixture of aluminium, composite and steel, depending on where on the car. So what we're talking, what, 1 mil thick aluminium, maybe a bit less. If you scaled that down 18 times, you're looking at almost paper thin aluminium, which leads me on to this. You can get proper modelling aluminium sheet, which is thicker than this stuff. I couldn't get hold of any. I'm going to try and adapt. I'm going to try and use several sheets of this stuff, thick baking foil. This is from Tesco. Many other brands are available. Just in case it's too thin, I got some of these, again, cheap old cooking tins from Tesco. The aluminium's thicker. I can sort of push out these little ridges and that lot. And hopefully I'll have to take some moulds off of that to make a negative, and then either make a negative and a positive and then clamp the aluminium between it and see if I can actually press it a bit, like how you would do it, how a normal mass-produced wing is made, or I'd have to try and sort of force it into the pattern. Now, on one of the scenes I want to do, or one of the tests, I wanted to sort of make some Armco barrier, which is obviously going to distort as the car hits it. So I've got a sheet of, this is two sheets of baking foil, just folded, and but then I ran it. As you can see, it's corrugated. It's normal, just flat sheet. I ran it through one of these. Now, this is a crafting or paper craft ridge thing. It makes corrugated designs. One year we tried making our own Christmas cards. That was a pain. It took so long. I mean, it's a nice touch, but it's anyway, we got one of these from Hobbycraft or wherever. And so I thought, oh, hang on a minute, let's put the aluminium foil through that, and it produced this corrugated aluminium, which is quite good for modelling if you was doing I don't know, scale model buildings that needed aluminium skin. Obviously it flexes that way, very rigid the other way because of the corrugations in it. Now obviously I'm going to, it's not a perfect copy, sorry if it's out of focus, hang on. It's not a perfect copy of Armco. I'll just trim it down to about 3 or 4 corrugations, put it on some posts, either made of aluminium rolled up or say dents, and then spray it a bit, and I'll do some tests. So yeah, that's the plan. Oh, the book, by the way, that the trailer is going to be for. It's called Siren Song. I'll put the link. The link is on my channel page, my front page, landing page, but I'll put the link in the information. This is the other car I got just in case I was going to do some other filming projects. This one is DBS, Aston Martin DBS, 1/14th scale, so that's quite big. Again, it's got sort of working suspension. Let me just try and get that in shot there. Made by Rastar, made in China. It's sort of radio controlled, but it's a bit crude. And there's no digital propulsion on it. Forward or back, left or right. The lights come on when you're sort of accelerating. Little LEDs in the front. Same with tail lights. But the detailing, I have to say, the detailing is rather good. Nice chunky model. It's made of polystyrene, plastic, injection molded. Needs a bit more detail. You might illuminate the dashboard, put some little fibre optics or LEDs in it. If I was going to turn it into a proper radio control model, I would put digital proportional servos in it. At the moment, this might be used for filming as well, just to show it off-roading. For the price, it's not bad. The only thing it doesn't have is opening doors, boot or bonnet. So I'm going to take a thin craft knife to that and start scoring the doors open. And because I mean, the inside of the doors, the door trim, I know you can't see in here, but it's actually it's fully detailed. But ideally, I'd love to have had the DB7 in this scale, 1/14, but I cannot find a 1/14 scale DB7. This is 1/18 scale, and anything really large tends to be in the price range that looks like a phone number, very specialised models. This is diecast, it's just a toy, and hopefully, like I say, that will be used in the film trailer. This will just probably be used in slow motion tests and other modelling tests, and all while I fit around all my other real car videos. Got the Citroen XM's, got some stuff I need to film on it, the Rover GTI, well, the outer door handle decided not to work, so I've got to sort that out. It's raining at the moment outside, so I've got to sort that out. I'll probably try and video that when the weather improves. So anything with having older cars is a basically constant fettling just to keep them going. So there you go. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video, as and when that will be. And yeah, take care. Enjoy your weekend. Bye for now.